all men were created equal. You know the saying. However, when it comes to a team, teams are not created equal. In a team, men are vulnerable, accountable for success and failure of their teammate and everybody around them. They must be willing to pick themselves up and their teammates up, even in defeat. They are always ready to band together, protect and defend each other by any means necessary, especially with the all barks and no bites. But don't even trip. You arrive at Exit 4, home of the Red Devils. No smoke screens, flashing lights, and definitely not no fire trucks. Just football.
I'm here with Coach John Emmel, head coach of the Pensacola football team. John, returning back to the Group 1 championship was a big objective for you guys after what happened last season. Talk to me about this season. How did you remain focused and how did you prepare for what's next to come?
Well, the goal every year for our program is to win the state championship. You have to get there in order to win it. Last year, reaching the final game and coming up short, I think it gave these guys a lot of motivation in the offseason. They worked hard through the summer. Maybe did some things a little extra to try to hopefully get them over the hump this year. And so far we're back here, and it's a big accomplishment. But again, the real goal is to win this Saturday.
We prepare ever since the season ended last year. We start coming in the weight room. We had a lot of summer sessions. We just put a lot of work in over the summer and during the season.
After coming over off of a tough loss in the championship last year to Paulsboro, we just worked on getting stronger and working on key mistakes from last year and just being more disciplined. Just stuff that'll help us improve and get better into reaching the championship this year.
Now, this next game is not only the championship, including the number one and number two seeded teams, but it's also a crosstown rivalry between Pensacola and Salem. How does that make you feel? How do you prepare for those
things? It's a tough game, definitely. A rivalry game right next door. A lot of people, family here and there. You know, we're friends. A couple of our teammates from there, one of our captains, they told me he grew up, born and raised in Salem. He's here now. He's a Red Devil.
Yeah, it's a big rivalry. See, I'm from Salem. I was born and raised there. But I try not to get too hung up on the name of the team and where they're from. I focus on the X's and O's of the situation.
It's for bragging rights. You don't want to be the one to lose that game. If they win, they're not going to stop talking about it. We're not going to stop talking about it. We win. So we just want to battle. At the end of the day, we brothers. But once we step on that field, we can't talk. But we can talk after.
Well, I mean, it's unique, not just because we're playing a crosstown rival. We're playing a team we only played 3 weeks ago. So you don't get that all the time at a game at this level. But our guys will be well prepared. It's always a tough game. We play them. It seems to come down in the fourth quarter last year and this year so far being no exception. At the end of the day, though, we talk about our approach to the game, and we try to control what we can control. And it's about the guys in our locker room. And if they execute, we feel as though we have the best team and we'll be successful.
And so it's been said that you guys have a lot of weapons on the field. I mean, pretty much any player can play any position on the field. But not only do you have 11 solid players on the field at any given time, you also have the 12th man, who's your supporting cast, your crowd, your parents, the people that are involved with this team. Talk to me a little bit about how they help you elevate yourselves this season.
Our fan support has been great all year. We're able to do some historic things. Opening with the first night game in school history against Pennsville, we had a huge crowd. We played Paulsboro and sold 2,600 paid attendance. Had homecoming game, a state champion from Tennessee, another night game with a big crowd. The playoffs are always our best attended games, it seems like, and this week will be no different. Salem is a tough place to play. Having this game at home, I think, gives us the advantage of being able to do our normal routine, be in our locker room, come in the same time we always come in, just make us a little more comfortable and hopefully give us an advantage when we have to go out there and play.
Now, the saying, don't even trip, you guys have been talking about that all year long. What's that saying mean to you? Where does it originate from?
See, yeah, we got it from one of our coaches, Coach Lee. I don't know where he got it from, but he started sending it around us, and we just picked up on it. After a while, we just told Emma, like, hey, let's make that our slogan, Coach.
We started this season on 7-on-7, and our coach had said, don't need a trip. But it's like, whenever somebody, like, tries to make it seem like we did something wrong, or if they made a big play, like, don't need a trip, I got you. We're going to come back with something stronger, you know?
In the games, when I'll be saying it, I be meaning like, don't even trip, like you knew what you was getting yourself into when you stepped on this field with us. We ain't come here to lose.
It originated from one of my coaches, Coach Lee. He just brung it up, being the like, when people get mad, we tell them don't even trip. They try to get in their heads, we tell them don't even trip, we'll be there, we'll be ready to play. We just let the pass do the talking.
Yeah, don't even trip has been our slogan. It's on our t-shirt for this year. You know, I talk to our seniors every summer before each season to kind of get an idea of what we want to do as far as a slogan to put on a t-shirt. And this year it was kind of brought up, don't even trip. And I kind of thought it was a joke, you know, because we want to always keep it, you know, positive. But, you know, to be honest with you, when we thought about it, it really is a great slogan for us because just for us it means, and to me it means, you know, don't worry about things you have no control over. You know, get the next play, do your job on the field, off the field. And you know, when you're in the weight room, when you're in practice, when you know the weather's bad, when you're down in the fourth quarter of a game or the second half, you know things can be tough. But don't even trip. You know, just keep focused on your job, and you'll be successful. And that's what we went by all year, and we're going to keep it going.
Coach John Emmo and his team will face off against Salem 12 p.m. on November 17th. Coach, we wish you the best of luck.
Hey, thank you.